My name is Elena Bradūnaitė-Aglinskienė. I'm an anthropologist ethnographer. Grew up in the United States, but have been coming to Lithuania since 92 on a pretty regular basis. And the last 2 years I've spent pretty much continuously in Vilnius. Vilnius was a city where my parents were students in 1940s before leaving as refugees. And they returned in 1990, right after the independence was declared. The best thing that happened to them was that they found Vilnius pretty much the way they had left it. The churches were all still in place, the bells were ringing the same notes that they remembered. And as they walked the streets, they said, if we don't look at our reflection, we feel like we're 25 and just engaged. They were 75 at that time. So for them, Vilnius came alive the way they had remembered it. And many friends that I have now who come and visit Vilnius, we celebrate the city for its unique historical sites, for its unique impression of the past that otherwise it's very difficult to find. Most old towns have been destroyed throughout Europe or minimized in size. Vilnius is large. UNESCO recognized it as a historical site, and I think that's one of the best attractions that Lithuanians have to present to the world. And it was very clearly understood that Vilnius will stay pretty much intact. Well, since then, of course, capitalism and all kind of interesting economical considerations and shenanigans, I would say, behind the scenes have changed some of the profiles of Vilnius's old town into the negative side. And one of the most obvious sites right now under consideration, well, it's actually being built, is a site near Missionary Church on an uphill part of where the vistas are beautiful of the old town. And they're building in apartments. At first it was supposed to be a hotel. Now it's changed to personal apartments. And it's a very modern glass format, I think, structures that will completely sit like a wound, actually, on the old town. And the sad part was that these decisions were made under very shady circumstances in who knows what kind of corners of deliberations and buildings of cities, officials, politicians, businessmen. But the decision was made that they can do it, and it really will be a sore site on that hill. The hill has been completely excavated at this point. To build something that's going to be so out of place, It will hurt Lithuania. UNESCO may reconsider its recognition of it as a historical city, the old town. And it's a shame that these kind of decisions are not discussed with the public. This is part of the Soviet legacy, I think, that leaves people in authority thinking that they can make decisions without much discussion or consideration or any kind of dialogue with the general public. General public is still viewed as someone below their intellectual expertise. One of the reasons I think people feel very much without any authority or any, they're not empowered to even think about some of the things because they really feel there's no way of affecting change. They haven't witnessed many examples of that. And I think this concern about Missionary Hill is one way that citizens can begin to feel empowered if they feel at least there's some reaction to their statement. Sole obligation still sits with the architects and those who are elected to be officials, public officials, that they would feel more of a responsibility to the general public and not necessarily to the economic business ventures, businessmen that are coming with very big offers and tempting, and how to resist those temptations and to feel more an obligation to the present day citizens and to the future. The future will pass judgment in the long run. In general, buildings really do capture a lot of history and pass it on to us in a very tangible, concrete way. Something that in this age of instant social communication and lots of information coming through Google, sometimes it's good to see a real tangible object that talks to you from the past. And buildings do that. Missionary, the space, I've walked many times on that hill. It's a beautiful, beautiful vista of the city. And the fact that when you're looking up towards the hill, the church rises up as a unique, unique architectural symbol of that Lithuanian Baroque Gothic, almost the lightness of the Baroque is very unique to Vilnius. And with a big building next to it, say it'd be glass, it's really going to detract from the play of the way that church plays with the natural hillside views from looking at it from the bottom. And I think that's something that everybody should take a real, real serious look on how it's going to change. It's most important is to realize that historical buildings present the history in a very real, tangible way that probably no other way can do it. So when you have a space that's already annihilated, your old building is gone, and building something completely out of context can really be very hurtful. It really destroys more than the bomb would during the war. In so many ways. And on Missionary Hill, putting up the new architecture there can be, it's a destruction. It's a destruction of a historical space that no longer will speak to us. It's like a war, destruction.